Hello students, myself Mrs. Kirti Pramod Sapare, working as senior lecturer at MC Society's Institute of Pharmacy, Pune. Today, we will discuss on Forms of Business Organization Part 1, that is second topic from Drugstore and Business Management. Let's begin. Learning Objectives. From this video, students will be able to classify forms of business organization, explain silent features, advantages and disadvantages of sole proprietorship, joint in the family business and partnership, describe kinds of partnership and partners. Reflection spot, that is question for the students. What do you mean by business organization? You have to write the answer in your notebook. Just pause the video and write the meaning of business organization. You can play the video once you have done. Forms of business organization. When the business is handled by an individual or group of persons, it is known as business organization. Business organization is classified into non-corporate and corporate. Non-corporate part is classified into sole proprietorship, example small-scale retail shop, partnership, example large-scale retail shop, and joint in the family business, while corporate part is divided into joint stock company, example Sun Pharma, Ranbaxy, etc., and cooperative society, example Sahakari Bhandar. Joint stock company is again divided into private company and public company. Corporate types required registration in a particular act, while non-corporate does not require registration. We will start with first type, that is sole proprietorship. Sole proprietorship. It is simplest form of business organization. It is also known as a one-man business in which one person is solely responsible for providing capital, for bearing the risk of the enterprise, and also for day-to-day management of business. When the business is owned by a single person, it is known as sole proprietorship. Let's discuss silent features of this sole proprietorship. First feature, that is single ownership. The ownership lies with one person only. Free decision making. Owner is free to take any decision over the business. Unlimited liability. Sole proprietorship has unlimited liability or responsibility. That is, all liabilities are on proprietor and creditors can recover their dues from the personal property of proprietor. Next is flexibility in pattern. Sole proprietor is free to change the pattern of management in any time. No sharing in a profit and losses. The profit earned and losses suffered in the business are borne by proprietor. Close contact with customer. Sole proprietorship is able to establish a personal contact with his customer. Quick decision making. Owner can make his own decisions as per market requirement. No legal status. The proprietor and the business is one and the same. Business secrecy. Business secrecy can be maintained in a sole proprietorship. Minimum government regulation. No legal formalities are required to start the business except medical shop, which require few legal formalities. Now we will discuss advantages and disadvantages with sole proprietorship. First we will begin with advantages part. Advantages of sole proprietorship. First, authority. Owner has full authority over the business. He is free to prepare any plans and policies without interference. Capital. Business can be started even with small capital. Capital can be increased or decreased at the will of proprietor. Employment. Employment of workers depends on the will of proprietor. Next, formation. It is very simple and easy. Overhead expenses of management are generally less. Personal contact. Proprietor have intimate contact with customer. Business secrecy, it can be maintained, and business wind-up is according to the will of proprietor. Next, disadvantages of this sole proprietorship. First, capital investment. It is always inadequate, so it is difficult to expand the business. Checks and controls cannot be seen as business is controlled by only one person. Death of owner, it ends the business. Single management, it is not possible for a single person to manage different activities like production, sales, advertising, etc. Unlimited liability, of course it is disadvantage, because if there is a raw risk or loss in the business, burden is totally upon sole proprietor. Next, limited finance. The business is run by the single person, so there are limited finances. Next, limited skills and abilities. It is not possible to possess knowledge in all respect for a single person, so there is limited skills and abilities. Now, we will move on next type of business organization, that is joint Hindu family business. A business which belongs to a single Hindu family and conducted as a family business is called as joint Hindu family business. The management and control of the family business is generally in the hands of senior most male member of the family, who is also known as a karta. So karta is a senior most male member who controls the business. Salient features of joint Hindu family business. First, membership. Membership arises from birth in the family. Next, male members carries the business. Female members cannot make any claim. Karta has whole rights to control the business. Liability of karta is unlimited, while liability of all other members is limited. Shares fluctuates. Shares of each member fluctuates. Shares increases on death of anyone and decreases by birth of new one. Ask for partition. Any member can ask for partition of the business. Unaffected on death of karta. Business is unaffected on a death of karta as next senior most member becomes karta for that family. Next, advantages and disadvantages of joint Hindu family business. First, we will start with advantages. First, cooperative effects or efforts. The various duties can be divided among members according to their capacity and ability. Freedom of karta. Karta has right to take any decision without interference of other. Equal shares. Irrespective of contribution in a business, every co-owner gets equal share in the profit. Sharing of knowledge and experience. Younger members can share knowledge and experience through their elders. Security. The business is like insurance cover for children, widows, disabled or sick members of the family. Smooth running of business is possible because of experienced seniors. Limited liability of members. Again, it is advantage as only karta has unlimited liability, while other members has limited liability. Next, disadvantages. First, continuity. It depends upon continuity of joint Hindu family itself. Irresponsible and lazy members get share in the income and profit of the business irrespective of their involvement in the business. Lack of motivation. There is no encouragement to work hard because person is not benefited for his hard work. Limited resources, as business is limited to one family. Karta may be unfair to the members as he has full power. And scope of misuse, karta may misuse his freedom for the personal benefits and the gains. Next, third organization, that is partnership. Indian Partnership Act defines partnership as a relation between persons who have agreed to share profit of the business carried on by all or any one of them acting for all. The person who have entered into partnership are individually known as partners, and collectively firm is known as partnership. The business organization runs on partnership is called as firm. Let's discuss salient features of partnership. First, number of persons, very important feature. Two or more persons up to maximum 20 and maximum 10 in case of banking firm are united together to form partnership. Next, partnership deed. Partnership is formed on the basis of an agreement. It might be oral or written with the concerned person. The document containing agreement is called as partnership deed. Profit distribution. Any profit made is distributed among the partners in proportion to capital invested. Share transferring. A partner cannot transfer his share to the outsider without consent of other partners. Unlimited liability. Each partner has unlimited liability. Liquidity. Partnership is dissolved automatically when the term for which partnership was entered into expires or when partner dies or retires. Continuity. In case partner dies or the firm dissolves, it depends on remaining partners whether to continue the firm or not. Every partner can manage the business. Next, advantages of partnership. First, business life. It is longer as it doesn't depend upon any one person. Decision to start a partnership is quite prompt since partners can meet as and when required. Efficiency is greater as interest taken by every partner in the management of the business. Expansion can be expanded by extending the partners but not exceeding 20. Formation, it is simple and easy to form as any two or more legally competent person may start the partnership after executing partnership deed. Finance. Partner may pull their individual resources to collect enough finance. Judgment. A balanced judgment is made regarding business issue, avoiding individual preferences. Risk per person is less as the losses incurred are shared by all. An unlimited liability. It serves as security to the creditor who are interested to invest the money. Disadvantages. First, lack of harmony. After working for some time, it becomes difficult to maintain mutual understanding and harmony among the partners. Lack of stability due to death, insolvency or retirement of a partner. Dishonest partner or incompetent partner may land the firm into difficulties. Withdrawal of capital. Partner will not be able to withdraw the capital unless all other partners agree on it. Living on a firm, it is quite difficult till all other partners agree to it. Limited resources, because legal limitation on a number of partners and person cannot be run or business cannot be run on a large scale. No secrecy is maintained and public faith is always less for partnership. Kinds of partnership. Partnership is divided into two types based on liability. General partnership and limited partnership. General partnership. Liability of each partner is unlimited. If assets of the firm are not sufficient to pay off its liabilities, private property of partners may be used. However, minor partner is an exception. General partnership is divided into three types. Partnership at a will, that is agreement to carry business without specifying any time, particular partnership, agreement to carry business for fixed period, joint venture, agreement for completing a specific task or project during fixed period with contribution of capital and sharing of profit and loss. Limited partnership. The unlimited liability of partners in general partnership discourages investment of large sum in the firm. In limited partnership, liability of partners are limited except that of one or more partners. It is not permitted in an Indian law. Such partnerships are found in a UK and US. Next, kinds or types of partners. First, we will discuss four types and then three types. First type, that is active partner. It takes active part in the management of a business, contributes capital, share profit and losses of the firm, and bears unlimited liability for debt. Sleeping partner. He does not take an active part in the management of business, contributes capital and shares profit and losses, and he has unlimited liability. Nominal partner. A person who lends his name to the firm as a partner. However, he neither invests capital nor claims in a profit and share of the business, and he doesn't take part actively in the management, and also he bears unlimited liability. Fourth type, that is partner in a profit only. A capital is invested with the view to earn a share in the profit of the firm. He also has no liability regards to losses suffered by the firm. Main objective of having such a partner in the firm to make use of his money and goodwill, and he bears unlimited liability for the day. Next, secret partner. A partner who does not want to be known as a partner of the firm to the outsider, though in reality he is a partner, is called as secret partner. His liability to the debt is unlimited. Minor partner. A partner below the age of 18 is a minor partner. He does not enjoy the rights of full-fledged partner in the partnership firm. Indian Partnership Act allows a minor partner, provided all partners agree for it. He shares the profit and property of the firm. His liability is limited. On attaining majority, he has a choice to continue as a partner. But if he doesn't give a public notice within 6 months, he continues as a partner and then his liability is unlimited. Last, partner by estoppel. If an outsider behaves in such a fashion that he is mistaken as a partner of the firm by third party, and he will be held liable to all those third parties who extend credit to the firm on assumption of his being a partner. Such a partner is known as a partner by estoppel. Because of his having behaved as a partner, he cannot deny the liabilities attached to the position. In an actual partner, partner by estoppel is not the partner of firm. He neither contributes any capital nor take part in the management of a business. Thank you very much.